Breaking: 11 Texas soldiers mysteriously drop dead, all had one horrific thing in common. 11 U.S. Army soldiers have been found dead on and off U.S. military base Fort Hood in Texas under mysterious circumstances. While working to determine how nearly a dozen young and healthy men were suddenly dropping dead, investigators found one chilling thing between them that they all had in common, showing this likely wasn't a coincidence at all. Over the past 3 months, police in Fort Hood have been overwhelmed with an unusual number of death investigations, all of whom have been Fort Hood soldiers who are dropping at an alarming rate. The most recent victim was 23-year-old Sergeant Alex Taylor of Texas City, Texas, who was found unresponsive while working Wednesday on the base. Now, the Army's Criminal Investigations Command is taking a closer look at Taylor's death, Stars and Stripes reported Friday. At this point in the investigative process, we do not suspect foul play, but have not completely ruled it out while we conduct a complete and thorough death investigation, Criminal Investigations spokesman Christopher Gray said. This response comes after a series of mysterious deaths started piling up, the first one occurring on October 12 and haven't stopped since. Another soldier was found unresponsive at work in that same month, and each month since, all being discovered in the same strange manner, all of which were healthy one day and dead the next. However, the next three deaths all shared something else in common that make their fatalities different than the first ones. 24-year-old Private Kevin Polino from Fort Hood died from a gunshot wound while he was off base as the first of three to have been killed in the same way, according to Stars and Stripes. Their deaths are also under investigation by the Army since answers into what happened was not immediately clear. Private Dakota Lee Stump, 19, was another of the long line of fatalities who was finally found almost a month after going missing on October 10 when he was declared as having gone AWOL. However, his body was found November 3 next to his flipped vehicle by soldiers conducting land navigation training just 100 yards from the road, an Army release stated. Three other soldiers, all from Fort Hood, died on November 12 in a suicide bomb attack at Bagram Air Base in Afghanistan. Staff Sergeant John Perry, 30, Private First Class Tyler Rubelt, 20, and Sergeant First Class Alan Brown, 46, the Houston Chronicle reported. There have never been so many deaths in one time among soldiers all from the same base. What's even more odd is that the mysterious fatalities happen in threes under the same circumstances. There definitely seems to be something intentional about the commonality of them all being from Fort Hood, since the pattern that's now evident can't just be a coincidence. Military bases across the United States have been on high alert for months after a series of security breaches and incidents have occurred. Now, we're getting word of injured special operations soldiers who have been rushed to local hospitals after what happened on base where these heroes thought they were safe. A massive explosion on base at Fort Bragg in North Carolina has injured at least 8 Special Operations soldiers today. This comes just weeks after 15 Marines were injured during transport when their transport plane crashed into a Mississippi field, and 3 Marines were killed in a crash off Australia's eastern coast this summer, according to UPROXX. Authorities are trying to determine how this could have happened today at Fort Bragg and have already discovered some unfortunate answers. This isn't the first incident to happen in the last several months on a U.S. military base, and probably won't be the last. However, the outcome is the most detrimental this year. The Daily Caller broke the tragic news and details of this event today, which unexpectedly injured these Special Operations soldiers. 8 soldiers were injured during a training exercise at the U.S. Army base at Fort Bragg, North Carolina, on Thursday, the military said in a statement. The soldiers hurt during U.S. Army Special Operations Command demolitions training were taken by air and ground to multiple local hospitals, the statement said. The extent of their injuries and cause of the incident were not released. Lieutenant Colonel Rob Bockholt, a base spokesman, said he could not confirm local media reports of an explosion occurring during the exercise. What exactly happened is under investigation, he said. On Wednesday, 15 Marines were injured when an amphibious assault vehicle caught fire during training at Camp Pendleton in California, the Marine Corps said. The conditions of the injured soldiers were not immediately made public and have yet to be determined. The Gateway Pundit reports that several were transported via emergency medical helicopter to the Womack Army Medical Center. What specifically caused the blast is still under investigation. There are injuries, but we don't know the extent, Special Ops Command Lieutenant Colonel Rob Buchholz said, according to Fox News. The incident at Fort Bragg comes just a day after a vehicle fire at Camp Pendleton in California left 15 Marines injured, 8 of them in the burn unit, following a training exercise accident, Fox News pointed out. The theory goes that one accident is bad luck, two is a coincidence, three is enemy action. Today's incident marks the second within just a couple of days, but could actually be the third, in a series of horrific events on bases. We previously reported of what could now be considered the first of this trifecta of tragic occurrences, which ended much differently than these most recent cases. Naval Station Norfolk, in Virginia, went on high alert after what was discovered underwater just outside the secured piers that surround it. Just like airspace around U.S. fighter jets, naval stations are surrounded by a defined barrier of protection. That was breached today with who was able to get dangerously close and why. The naval station is guarded by sailors who work watch in shifts for anything or anyone who may pose a threat. This particular base contains 60 warships, including the fleet's newest and most technologically advanced aircraft carrier, the USS Gerald R. Ford, the Associated Press reports. This carrier had recently returned to the pier following a successful test of new equipment that launches and lands jet fighters. There are a lot of adversaries who could try to infiltrate our military in a mode of attack, which is why it's important to have sailors monitoring the base and its 14 piers at all times. Today, the spotted something amiss in the water which had encroached upon a no-go zone for anyone who is not authorized. The Washington Post reports. Officials say a scuba diver appears to have breached a barrier at the country's largest naval base and they have stepped up security as a result. Navy spokeswoman Kelly Werfel said several sailors on watch at Naval Station Norfolk in Virginia briefly saw the person Monday in the water near the secured piers. A security gate sits in the water surrounding the base and its 14 piers. Werfel says security teams are looking for the person while restricting access to and from the piers. Adding to the cause for concern was that Werfel said, it was not a Navy diver, and they also confirmed that there were no divers in the water for maintenance. Now we have three very alarming events which have occurred on U.S. military bases within the last couple of months. This could be a coincidence or perhaps something more deliberate. Regardless of the cause, our American heroes need to stay vigilant and on high alert even when on base after what we've seen in the last couple of years, that these secured places are susceptible to attack.